Good morning, sir.
Good morning, everybody, and thank you all for coming, especially the alumni of the junior college. I'm very, very happy to note that all of you are very accomplished ladies now. Yeah, I wish I could attend all your sessions, but I have a very urgent meeting, so I would see all what you have to say through the YouTube later. Okay, yes. So Asha ma'am, you can take over. Thank you, yes. Once again, all of you, and all the very best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
The college produces excellent, talented students with remarkable achievements in various fields, in sports, academics, and even in extracurricular activities. I am proud to announce that our students played multiple roles as advocates, artists, actors, teachers, and chartered accountant holders, etc. I would like to appreciate all the efforts of our students for the development of the society as the responsible citizens of the country. A very warm welcome to our alumni passed out students from this prestigious institution for this event. I'm happy to announce that we invited for this function Siddhika and Sania, founder of Good Mind, Spandana, chartered accountant, senior auditor, Deloitte, Shelly Rangaraj, global placement, senior human resource specialist, Malavika Anand, the world record holder for singing, Yuvagana Kokila, and Chandrareka, freelance assistant director in Telugu cinema. Once again, I welcome you all girls for our institution. Now, I request Mrs. Deepa Rani Avasthi, Vice Principal, to address our alumni.
Thank you, Lakshmi Madam. Good morning to one and all.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Sri Kishan Bhadruka ji, Sabha Nirdeshak Sri Abhiram Krishna ji, Nirdeshak G.S. Rao ji, Pradhan Acharya, Srimati Asha Rani, Anya Atithi Gan, aur mere priya sahyogiyon, tatha hamare sabhi purva chhatraon ko दीपा रानी अवस्थी वाइस प्रिंसिपल हिंदी फैकल्टी का प्यार भरा नमस्कार। हमारे संस्थान भद्रका जूनियर कॉलेज फॉर गर्ल्स की पूर्व छात्रा मुलाकात समारोह के इस शुभ अवसर पर आप सभी विद्यार्थियों को संबोधित करने का मौका पाकर मैं अपने आप को बहुत ही सम्मानित महसूस कर रही हूँ। आज का दिन हमारे लिए बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण है क्योंकि यह हमें कई पूर्व छात्राओं के साथ काफी लंबे समय बाद मिलने का अवसर प्राप्त हुआ है। तो आज के इस महत्वपूर्ण समय का सदुपयोग करते हुए बड़े ही उत्साह और उत्तेजना के साथ हम आपसे अनुरोध करते हैं कि आप अपने कॉलेज की नव छात्राओं को अपने यहाँ बिताए यादगार पल, अपने जीवन में शिक्षा व शिक्षक का महत्व, माता पिता का साथ, आपकी लगन मेहनत सभी को साझा करें। मुझे आज भी याद है कि किस तरह आप अपने लक्ष्यों को प्राप्त करने के लिए मेहनत और चिंता करते थे, लेकिन वही मेहनत व लगन आज आपकी सफलता की कुंजी बन गई है। आपसे अनुरोध है कि आप अपनी कॉलेज की नव छात्राओं को बाहर की दुनिया के अनुभव, अपने जीवन के अनुभव बताए। मैं व अपना भद्रुका परिवार आप सभी का बहुत ही शुक्रगुजार है। आप सभी ने कम समय में हमारे द्वारा दिए गए आमंत्रण को स्वीकार कर कुछ समय हमारे साथ बिताने तथा नव छात्राओं का मनोबल बढ़ाने के लिए यहाँ उपस्थित हुए हैं। हम जानते हैं कि आपके व्यस्त कार्यक्रम से कुछ समय निकालकर यहाँ आने में या उपस्थित होने में आपको बहुत ही दिक्कत हुई होगी, लेकिन मेरा मानना है कि आपके जीवन के अनुभव आज की नव छात्राओं को एक नई प्रेरणा देगा और नए जीवन नए लक्ष्य की ओर बढ़ते कदम में साथ देगा। आशा है कि यह पुनः मिलन की व्यवस्था आप सबको पसंद आए और यादगार रहे। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू दीपा मैडम फॉर एन इंस्पायरिंग स्पीच एंड रिकलेक्टेड अवर ओल्ड मेमोरीज दैट वी स्पेंट इन द कॉलेज। थैंक यू वेरी मच। प्लीज ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ओपन योर वीडियोस एंड कीप योर ऑडियो म्यूट। Keep your audio mute and open your videos. All the students, participants, open your videos so that we can take a photo. Be ready for a snap.
Ma'am, you count 1, 2, 3, ma'am. Then we'll be ready. Hi, Lakshmi, ma'am. This is Chandralekha from 2012 batch.
Nice to hear you. We will do the counting.
Yeah. Yes, ready, be ready. Open your videos. 1, 2, 3.
Ma'am, we are still holding the poses. Is it over?
Girls, please, aap log aapka video on rakhiye beta. Aur haska hua chehra bataiye aap log. Please ready. 1, 2, 3. Hasta hua chehra, khilta hua phool. Phir se ek baar. 1, 2, 3. Girls, video on kariye. गर्ल्स फोटो लेना है, हंसते हुए चेहरे की फोटोज लेना है। प्लीज वीडियो ऑन करिए। गर्ल्स
Now, I request Mrs. T. Asharani Madam, Principal of Bhadrika Junior College for Girls, to share few moments of pride with our students. Over to Asha Madam.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Madam. Thank you very much. Good morning to all invitees. colleagues and my dear students. I'm principal of Junior College. It gives me an immense pleasure to welcome our alumni for our orientation program. It has provided the opportunity to meet you all, no matter virtually. I understand you're equally busy with your schedule, but spared your time, which is worth doing, because you can share your experiences, hardships, and achievements with freshers. Like a potter shapes a pot out of clay, you can mold the upcoming students with your innovative ideas. You can motivate, guide, and can bring a drastic change in their lives. It's like going back to good olden days. We shall dive into the old memories with nostalgia and relish the best days of our lives. Our alumni has brought a great glory to our institution. They have set an example of being successful, and they have been successful in various fields like chartered accountant, company secretaries, directors, artists, professors, and entrepreneurs. I would like to praise the multiple roles played by them in our society. I would like to appreciate the efforts of all the alumni, being whatever they have done for the development of our society and justifying the years that they have spent with us and in our esteemed institution. We have embarked on a mission to empower the girl students with light of knowledge. And our concern is to have a wide parameter, such as making our students a good citizens globally as they establish themselves in a larger outer world. So it's my advice to all the freshers to get benefited from this session, the talk which they are going to share. And the alumni who has been invited today, they were the excellent performers, okay, in academics as well as co-curricular activities. So you have to listen to them, understand them, and implement whatever they say, and you can do your level best to bring out best results out of your hard work, okay, which will lead to your successful career. So it's a moment of real pride for all of us to welcome our alumni, okay, on this occasion, okay? So it's a request to all the freshers to get motivated, inspired, and follow the footsteps of our alumni, okay? Thank you very much.
Ritu.
Thank you all. Over to you, ma'am.
Madam, for your encouraging and motivational speech.
आप वो कॉल पे करता बोला देख कैसा करता वो कर दे.
All
more लगता.
So all the students keep your audio mute, please. Now the address by alumni. The name and fame of any institution not only depends on its administration and achievements of students, and also that is we are all proud and lucky to have such talented students as alumni. I congratulate them for their achievements and efforts made by them. Now, I would like to invite and request Siddhika and Sania, founder of Good Mind, to express their views and share their experiences with our students. Please, over to Siddhika.
Okay, ma'am, can you hear me? Am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay, good morning, ma'am. Good morning, all the newbies, and good morning to all the alumni. I am super happy to be here. Thank you so much for inviting me. It's an honor. And I have missed you all, first of all. I missed all the teachers.
Yeah.
How are you, ma'am? Is everything all right?
Fine.
All are good.
We are all good.
Good morning, everyone. I am Siddhika. We are from the 2017 and 2018 batch. And I am an actual entrepreneur and I work towards making mental wellness accessible and affordable. So my startup is GoodMind. So I'll tell you a little about what is GoodMind first. So GoodMind is a mental wellness platform that makes mental wellness accessible, affordable, while maintaining the complete anonymity of our patients. So we provide individuals who are seeking help with AI-powered assessment tests, stigma-free counseling sessions from the best therapists from around the world at their fingertips. So this is what we do, and we started off when we were in the first year of our graduation college, and the faculty, let me tell you all the newbies, you guys are super lucky to be here. I mean, first let me congratulate for this, because Bhadruka is a great opportunity if you want to do anything, because you know, the DG sir, the principal sir and the secretary sir has been a great help to all of us, has been a great help to me, has been a great help to GoodMind. They've helped us throughout. And, you know, recently we have launched one of our products in GoodMind. It is called the Center of GoodMind. As soon as college reopens, you guys can come and visit the center. So they've been a great help in setting that up. So you guys are at a great place and utilize this opportunity as much as you can. I mean, you know, you can do a lot with the help of this faculty. And, you know, the journey, you know, me and Sania had in the junior college is really special. You know, it will always hold a special place in our heart because those 2 years were really special. We enjoyed a lot. We, you know, we learned a lot. You know, these very talented teachers have taught us a lot. I have learned. Oh, sorry, is there any disturbance? Okay, so I have learned a lot, especially, and I have, you know, grown a lot in those 2 years. I learned how to, you know, have a vision. I learned how to, you know, have patience and, you know, work on my skills and everything. And that is what helped me in doing my startup in the very first year of college. So one little advice for the newbies is start early if you want to do startups. Because, you know, starting early will help you explore new things. And that is one thing that will help you in not failing at it. So when you start early, you explore a lot of things. Because, you know, you just passed your school and you're here. And the world is a crazy place. And, you know, there are hell lot of opportunities and things to explore outside. So if you are interested in any of these entrepreneur things, please reach out to me. I would be very happy to help you guys. And just start off by, you know, learn anything you want, because
girls, please mute yourself. Excuse me. Sinika, 2 minutes. I request all others to mute yourself. Yes, you can continue, please.
I was saying that Bhadruka is a great opportunity, and you know, you have to make the most of it. If you are in the college, please make the most of it and, you know, explore all the things you can, learn all the things which you can. And now I would like Sania to share the journey of GoodMind and our journey with college.
Yes. Hello, good morning everyone. I hope I am audible. Am I?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much for having us. It's so delighted to be here and share our experience. Coming from that stage and sharing our experience is such a wonderful and pride moment for me especially. So yeah, we started when we were in, like Siddhakha said, we started when we were in our first year. It was on September 10th. Lockdown just ended and we were just thinking of everyone were bored at home. So we wanted to utilize it some or the other way. And then we heard about Adventure Park. Adventure Park has, we had an imposition when we were in our first year in degree college, it was about entrepreneurship development. And then we were quite inspired by it. And then we were thinking of ideas and all, like how to apply and how can we solve a problem? How can we be an entrepreneur? Until then, we didn't even know the word of entrepreneur and how entrepreneurship looks like. And today we are young student entrepreneurs. That's a matter of pride for us, and it was completely about entrepreneurship and all. And then what happened after a few days after that in position, we were just on a random call, I and Siddhaka, and we were discussing about our rough day and we were sharing our experiences. And then we came up with something like call just started by sharing all these and ended by realizing many other things. We realized ki usually when we have any kind of physical symptoms, we go to hospitals and get ourselves checked. But when we have any kind, when a person needs any kind of mental support or when they need mental help, we end up being blank. So that is when we realize we don't give as much as importance to our mental health the way we give to our physical health. That is when we came up with an idea of Good Mind, wherein, like Siddhaka said, to make mental health accessible, affordable, while maintaining the complete anonymity. And since then, our journey began as an entrepreneur. Coming from commerce background, we had no idea of all these technical things. And ours is a website. And, when we were in our pre-incubation stage at Adventure Park, we were doing good with all the things like... If it was related to commerce and all, we were doing it well. But coming to technicality part, we were always backward because we were from commerce background and we had no idea of any kind of technicality and all. And then we had a few people coming forward to help us as a pro bono. And then it took for 5 months, I guess. For 5 months, we were completely online. I mean, like, we had no progress and we had no one to support us with technicality thing and all. And then after, it was in the month of May when we decided ki, like, kuch bhi ho job, we should not wait for anyone and we need to do it and we need to make it happen. So that is when, we literally didn't sleep for more than 15 days. We worked day and night for 15 days to get our product ready and launch it. And we have finally launched Good Mind on Product Hunt on 11th of May. And, immediately the other day, we were ranked world number 3 product of the day on Product Hunt. And that was a very pride moment for, it's not a small thing to rank number 3 in across the world. And that really made us very happy. And that was one of our best day and best launch. So yes, that's when our actual struggle began. After struggling for more than 9 months, we finally came up with it. We tried to find more and more solutions. We brainstormed on each and everything. And when during this journey, we have spoken to more than 100 doctors and we got few, yes,
Hello. I guess there is some issue with the internet. I just check with her. So I'll continue what you're saying. So today we launched. The other day we made the top 3 words. Hello. Am I audible, guys?
Yes.
Okay. As you were saying, our journey was not easy because first of all, we were not from the psychology background. And second of all, we had no idea of any of the technical things like coding. Had no idea. So these two were the very difficult parts and these were the very interesting parts of our journey. Because we were in the psychology thing and we had to build a website. So it was difficult, but then we figured it out with the help of all the supportive mentors we have. And, it's been a crazy journey because we have collaborated with a lot of NGOs and one of the North America-based NGO, it is a award-winning social impact startup named Invicta. They reached out to us a few weeks ago for collaboration and Jayashrandan inaugurated. He's the principal secretary of government of Telangana. He inaugurated and he asked us for a collaboration for a COVID center. He asked us whether we can, you know, set up a counseling center at the COVID center, which is, you know, being prepared for the third wave. And so that is what we've been doing. So Sania, you want to continue?
I'm so sorry, there was a connection problem. That is the reason I had to leave. So yes, I hope Sudhakar told you about Center of Good Mind. Yeah.
No, I haven't actually. You got to do it.
Okay. What did you tell?
I was talking about collaborations.
Okay, yes. We have collaborated with NGOs and all. And then we have conducted our very first inquisition to create awareness about mental health and conducted art therapy sessions. And also, you know, but during this time, we were to create awareness in society, especially among students regarding mental wellness and mental health. We were conducting sessions in colleges as well, like Shadan, KVBRR and many other colleges. And, you know, being in second year and being students, we were called as guest speakers. And that was a very happy and proud moment for both of us. And, you know, we were just it's not like within this small age, we have achieved a lot. There's still a long way to go. But yet, being a student and going to college as a guest speaker and talking there as a guest speaker, that's something huge for us. That was a very emotional moment for both of us. Like, yes, we are making things happen. And like I said, faculty, complete faculty, you know, everyone have been our major support in doing all these things and making all this happen. And while doing all these sessions, we came up with the idea of Center of Good Mind, like a Center of Good Mind wherein that focuses on students' mental wellness. And we have inaugurated our very first Center of Good Mind at Bhadruka College recently on 26th of June. And Mr. Jayashrandan sir, IAS, Principal Secretary, IT and INC departments of Telangana, you know, he has inaugurated our Center of Good Mind. And the other day, we were featured in 4 newspaper articles. And that was the very first time when Good Mind was featured in newspapers. And yes, that's how our journey began. And there were many ups and downs, you know, right? Entrepreneurship journey is not easy at all. There will be ups and downs, but it the only thing that matters is not to give up and not to lose hope. Everyone were there when we lost it, but we never gave up. That is the only thing you need to keep in mind. I mean, yes, that was our journey, few insights of our journey. Over to you, Sudhakar, if you have anything to add.
Yeah, so I just want to add a little bit here. I mean, whatever you guys decide to do, I mean, let that be entrepreneurship, let that be anything in the world you want to do, it's not going to be easy because, you know, these days there is a lot of competition in every field. Every field, there is a lot of competition. And, you know, just one thing that will keep you going is the passion you have for it. So me and Tanya, our journey was like a roller coaster. So we went up, up, up for a few months and a sudden crash down and we were on floor for 5 months. So the only thing that kept us alive during those 5 months, kept a good mind alive for those 5 months was our passion for it. We wanted it so bad. We wanted everyone to have access to mental wellness, everyone to, you know, make it affordable. We wanted to make it affordable so bad that we were like, no, no matter what, no matter how long we have to wait for it, we will do it. That's one thing I request all of you to develop during these days, because these are very important days. You know, school may, a lot of you might have been serious because we were not serious when we were in school. We were the most fun and these kind of girls. But then when we came to college, we realized that there is a lot of things to explore. There is a lot to learn. There is a lot to do outside. So, you know, you got to learn that thing. You got to have patience. You got to trust the process and also have this passion that will keep you alive no matter what you're doing. Because, you know, during this entrepreneur journey, I don't know about the rest of the fields because we haven't tried it yet. So entrepreneur journey is not easy, as Sanya said. You know, it's not going to be easy. It's like you will be punched in the face and expected not to cry. So we have been punched in the face for so many times, and you know, we were expected to smile. We were expected to take it with a, you know, sportsman spirit kind of thing. So you got to learn that thing. You got to, you know, have that thing. You got to have passion. You got to have dedication for whatever you are doing. And we are always here. If anybody of you, as I mentioned earlier, have any zeal or, you know, a small spark or interest or curiousness about entrepreneurship, we will be very, very happy to help you guys. Because as long as soon as the college reopens, you guys will see us in the center of Goodmind, also the innovation hub of Bhadruka. So we are the initiators of those of that hub. So we will be there in that office. If you want to, you know, meet us, please come and say hi. We will be really, really happy to help you guys and, you know, have a talk with you guys. So I guess that's it from my side. It's been it's really making me, you know, happy that I'm here meeting my teachers and speaking to all the talented people and, you know, sharing this virtual stage with all of my newbies. So welcome to the college, guys. It's gonna be a crazy ride. I hope you will enjoy. You will learn. I hope you, you know, do whatever you have always dreamt of doing. I wish you all the success and have a great day. What to you, ma'am? Also, sorry, I forgot to mention, if you guys have any questions, if you guys have any questions relating to the Center of Goodmind, to Goodmind, or anything related to entrepreneurship, you can ask us as long as we are here, or you can just, you know, DM us on our Instagram platforms. I'll put it in the chat box if you want. So, yeah, we are here if you have any questions.
Thank you very much, Siddhik and Sania. Thank you very much. Very excellent ideas for serving the people. Very nice. I congratulate both of you and all the best. And see that you must become just like a millionaire and billionaires. So you must develop. So it's a great encouragement to our students also. Thank you. Thank you very much. And the next participant invite me, Spandana. Spandana. Hello.
Hello, everyone.
She was very good student in the class, hard worker. She completed, she was working under Deloitte. As senior auditor. Over to Spandana. Good morning.
Firstly, good morning, ma'am. And morning. It's so good to see you, everyone, after such a long time.
We are
time.
Not able to see
in person. Yeah, virtual. Yeah. It's so great to see you all. And it's been very long since I've met everyone. Yeah, firstly, thank you for giving me this opportunity to talk to the girls regarding my journey. So thank you so much for inviting me. So good morning, girls. I hope you're having a good time. It's your second day of your orientation, and you got to know a little about the ma'ams and a little about the college and everything. So I think it's like too many thoughts in your mind as to, you know, you're freshly out of schools, as to how the colleges will be, what shall we do? So many questions, right? Like even I went through this. So just one thing, this college is the best for whatever you're going to do. And today, whatever I am, Bhadruka has been, you know, part of, I mean, for me, this college is like part of my life. For whatever I am today, Bhadruka is the reason. So, yes. So, welcome everyone and to this college. I welcome you all and I hope you will have a very good time during these 3 years. Trust me, girls, these 2 years, you will have so much of fun. At the same time, you will have to concentrate on your careers as to what you're going to do, how you're going to do, that is very, very important. You will have to strike that balance as to, yes, enjoyment is very important. At the same time, you will have to also make sure that you are going forward in your career. So for me, I wanted to be a chartered accountant, and Bhadruka has helped me a lot, like how this college is best for commerce. We all joined for that reason, right? Because this is one of the best college for commerce. So even I joined like that, knowing it from different people, like, yeah, this is a good college. So I had many questions, but see, I'm here, I'm a chartered accountant, I've achieved what I wanted to be. And also, so this chartered accountant journey was not easy. Like, you need to, people say that you need to study for 18 hours a day. You need to put a lot of hard work. Even if you study, you keep failing. Yes, it's all there. But one thing you'll have to remember is that zeal to become something. If you have that, nothing can beat us. So, yes, the journey has not been very, very, it was not easy though, because you see your friends and everyone, they might be enjoying, because CA is like something, you'll have to get up early in the morning, you have to go to your classes, then attend that, then come to college, again attend classes, then go back, again evening classes. It's not easy, right? Because you see your friends going out for movies and everything. But trust me, we'll have to make out time for everything. I'm the one who enjoyed so much during these 2 years. I must say, like, whenever, I sit and think back, the days when I enjoy, it would be these 2 years. Because ma'ams made that possible, like being, taking us for trips, excursions, and the crowd you meet here, girls, are awesome. Like, I'm sure you're going to make friends for life. Like, I have my friends from winter, like, we are too close. We come to college, sit under the tree, chat, talk to madams. It's all, you are going to make memories for life, that much I can assure you. So when I was in school, I would always hesitate, like, to talk to people. What would the other person think? Oh, no, I'm not going to talk. But this college, like, I came here, I met this crowd, these madams, they're like too warm. You go to them having some problem, like, be it Lakshmi ma'am, Asha ma'am, we used to go sit in the, I used to go chat with them in the staff room. We used to have so much good time. Like, I was so hesitant to talk to one or two people. Now I'm able to address you all. So that's the change this college has brought in me. I'm really, really glad that I'm part of this college, and I'm happy for you guys, because you're also going to become part of this college. And sorry, you are part of this college now. So make the most out of it. Grab every opportunity, and never lose hope. Hope is the thing which keeps you motivating every day. So never lose hope. And coming to my chartered accountancy journey. So yes, I wanted to become chartered accountant from my schooling days. I heard people saying that it's a very tough thing. No, don't do it. It's okay. You just go for an MBA, get a job. Then I was like, no. Let me do this, because I want to do this. How this thing started off, I went to my dad's friend, who is a chartered accountant. I went to his office. Then I heard that uncle saying that we just look into this financials and we sign. We assure and we give assurance to people saying that, yes, this organization is doing well. And I was like, it's some kind of, it sort of attracted me. You get to do so much, and people will be waiting for you and stuff. So I was like, okay, this is something. I don't know, it sort of attracted me. And then then my parents were like, do you really want to do it? Come on, because it's not going to be easy. Do you really want to do it? Then I was like, no, I will do it. Then I joined Bhadruka. Then I joined my CA foundation, which is now CA foundation, was then CPT in Bhadruka itself. So then mornings we used to have classes. Then we used to have college again, like in the same college. Like I used to sit in the same classroom. Morning it used to be CA foundation, and then the college would start. But trust me, like initially it was very difficult, like doing this and that. I used to feel like strained above. I would be like, okay, but still there was something which was keeping in me, no, let me do it. Then things started to get better. Like how? Because I started to connect things. Whatever I was learning in CPT, like I was applying in my CA intern. Like studying is a little boring. Okay, trust me, it is boring. But you will have to make it interesting. How? So I used to learn. It's the same subjects, same accounting you learn in college, same accounting you learn in CA foundation. But yes, in CA foundation we learn everything in little depth. Like be it economics or commerce or accountancy, you keep learning things like in little depth. And coming to college, you how much ever is necessary for your exams, that much you are taught. So I started to link things. I used to make notes. Still now I have this habit. Like I, maintain my notes very colorful. Like different colors of pens and all I used to use. And I mean, I try to make things little fun for me. You know, anyways, it's not fun. So let me do it something in an interesting way. So that at least, now I have all my notes piled up. Like whenever I look at them, I feel so happy. It's all colorful and stuff. So I keep sharing my notes. So that's how. So you will have to, bring that whatever brings in joy for you, so that you are not demotivated on or stuff. Then, so I finished my intermediate. Then come CPT exams. Then I was like totally blank. What to do? People have already planned, and then I have my CPT exam in 1 month. I was busy studying for intermediate. What should I do? Then I had literally 1 month. I sat down. I just, my dad, he was like, no, you don't do this. Just do an MBA. Why do you want to take so much of strain? This is not going to be easy. Then I was like, no, let me do it. Just give me one chance. He was like, yeah, just write for this time. If you're not going to clear your CPT, then gone. So I had only one chance in my life. Like if I wouldn't clear that attempt, maybe I wouldn't be a chartered accountant today. I would be maybe just done my MBA as my father wished. But I had just that one chance, and I had only 1 month, girls. Then, that 1 month, I just sat down, locked in my room, just studied, nothing else. I didn't let any other thought. I didn't even think what I'm going to do if I fail. I didn't even plan whether I should request my dad, please just give me another. Nothing came into mind. Just only one thing I had in my head was, I'm going to crack that exam. And just trust me, I cracked that. And my father had no chance to talk again. And today he's very proud that I'm a chartered accountant. So yes, girls. So that is what zeal is. Very, very important. You should have passion for things, whatever it is. Not because I had interest in chartered accountancy. Yes, I did. But you might be having different passions, right? So don't always have passion for something. You should, now that I'm a chartered accountant, it's not that I don't have goals. You should be having those. Goals are very, very important, and they always keep us motivated. So yes. And also, it is not that I was just a chartered accountant. I also got an opportunity to teach CA foundation in the same Bhadruka college. So where I have learned, I got an opportunity to teach. So yes, teaching is one of my passions. So I just want, so now that I'm a chartered accountant, I'm working. I also want to explore a new thing. So every day morning I would come teach. I mean, it used to get so much of, positive energy from the new people. It's all new crowd, like just out of the college, your thoughts are very fresh. So it was an amazing journey. So girls, grab every opportunity, be on your toes, have fun. Have fun, very, very important, because you know, as your previous speaker, Sania and Siddiqui, congratulations, girls. Mental well-being nowadays is very, very, very important. So yes, your mental well-being is also important. It's not only like always should be studying, study. You should take time for yourselves, have fun, and make very, very good friends. So, yes. So any questions you guys want to like feel free to unmute yourselves and any questions. And not only now, anytime regarding anything, if you have any questions, you can always reach out to me. Always welcome.
Very much, Spandana, for your motivational and encouraging speech, and which is very helpful to our students. What is going on in the college? So
yeah,
you told the entire thing till you settled.
Yes.
So very, very nice, very nice. So sweet of you. So we
thank
feel
so
very
much,
proud
ma'am.
Of you.
So thank you so much, ma'am.
Want to become chartered accountant, so they can know about, they can learn from her.
Okay,
thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's all because of you, ma'am, whatever I am today. So
thank
I'm
you.
Very, very proud to be of this
very great
part of this organization.
Yeah, it's very great. Nice, very nice. Take care. Bye.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Bye.
Okay, all the best. Okay. Yes, now we have short break, girls, but students should be online only. Short break we have. We'll play Bhadrika anthem in the short break.
పులకించును ప్రతి ఒక దేహం
ఏ మందిరమున జయ జయ హో అని వినిపించును భవిష్యత్ గీతం ఆ దివ్య క్షేత్రమే భద్రుకా మా బంగారు భవితకు వేదిక
ఈ కోవెలలో కాలిడిన క్షణం గుడి గంట నేలను తాకిన మరు నిమిషం పులకించును ప్రతి ఒక దేహం
భాగ్యమై నడుమ నిలచే భద్రుకా సంస్థానం
వీడని దీక్షకు ప్రతిరూపం నీడిది అందరి పుణ్యస్థలం
ఓ భద్రుకా నీకు వందనం వర్ధిల్లు నీ కీర్తి కలకాలం
కులకించును ప్రతి ఒక్క దేహం
Thank you. దోషములాడని యోగులు మాకు చదువులు చెప్పే గురువులు
విధులను మరువని విబుధులు మదిని వినయము నింపిన విదురులు
అడిగిన తడవుగా తెలియనివి కడువోర్పుతో నేర్పే కోవిదులు ఆచార్యులు మా ప్రియ నేస్తాలు
ఈ కోవెలలో కాలిడిన క్షణం గుడి గంటై మ్రోగులు హృదయం ఏ నేలను తాకిన మరు నిమిషం పులకించు ప్రతి ఒక దేహం
మెరుగని సమాజం కలసి సాధిస్తామని చాటుదాం
మహనీయులుగా మనుషులనే మలచే అభినవ గురుకులమే మా భద్రత విద్యా నిలయం మా అందరి సుందర ఉద్యానం
Thank you.
Ma'am, we want to talk to you, ma'am. Break only, no, ma'am. We'll talk.
Yeah, yeah. I told. I informed.
How are you, ma'am? So, ma'am's mic is on mute.
Yeah.
Microeconomics. Shelly, you're in office, right?
Yeah, dude. I'm in office. It's like we get to meet only during Bhadruka occasions.
Yeah.
Last time I met you was during some freshers party.
Yeah, we should meet more often.
Yeah.
Good to see you, Shaili. Hi, Chandrika.
Hi, ma'am.
It's Pandana.
Oh, Pandana. Oh. How are you, Pandana?
I'm good. How are you?
I like your wallpaper also, and also I'm glad. I'm happy for you. USBA, you worked really hard to make it.
Thank you so much. I mean, I've seen you're an assistant director. So nice here. Interesting job.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Are you guys eating something in the break? I'll go get some food.
Yes, please. अभी यहाँ पे भद्रुका का कैफेटेरिया तो नहीं है, but you can grab something from your kitchen.
Oh yeah, I miss the cafeteria.
I'll tell daddy that you guys are missing.
He's been happy. Yes, especially the dosa.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, Spandana?
Yes.
So please, can you put the host to Bhadrika College?
Okay. So am I the host?
Yeah.
No, I didn't know. One second.
This is not coming, that's why.
Okay. Okay.
Admit karo.
Yeah, yeah. One second. Make a host. Yeah. Done, ma'am.
Done.
Yeah. Now, Bhadrika College is the host. Yeah.
Hello to all the participants. Again, we are resuming.
Yes.
And because of some network problem, we couldn't play this Bhadrika Anta. Now I'm continuing the session program. Okay, time also very short is there. So now I request Shaili Rangis, a global placement senior human resource specialist, a smiling and charming girl, a magician.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Shaili.
Yes, ma'am, I'm here.
Yeah. So, I welcome you. I request you express your views and share your experiences with our students on this occasion. Please carry on. Over to you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. It's an absolute, moment of pride to be here back and, sharing my journey, my experience with everybody out there who are on the Zoom call.
Yes, yes.
So, yes. Hello and good morning, everyone. Sorry. Good afternoon, everyone. Firstly, thank you, ma'am, for such a warm welcome. So even before I introduce myself and start talking about my journey, my hardship, my wins and all, I would like to take this opportunity and thank the Bhadrika family for inviting me and having me here for this amazing connect that we are having. It just feels so, so good to, you know, still have that same bond, same feel, same connect with Bhadruka, exactly how I had years back. And I strongly believe that, you know, the person I have become today and I have grown up to, Bhadruka plays a very major role. So, yeah, the woman I am, leading the life I want, is all because of Bhadruka, I would say. So Bhadruka journey plays a very, very vital role, right? From being that timid, shy girl. I mean, people who have been with me in my class know what kind of girl I was, to the woman leading the life of her dream. So it gives me immense pleasure and a proud moment, I would say, to have been a part of this amazing family. And yeah, I don't miss any opportunity to, you know, let people know that I started my journey, my education journey, right from this family. And I absolutely take pride in guiding people to start their journey right from Bhadruka. So yeah, I have two of my cousins who did their inter and graduation from Bhadruka, and my own sister is actually doing a graduation from Bhadruka. So yeah, that's a short feeling that I wanted to share with before I get started. But yes, hi all, this is Shelly Rangrace for you all. So a pass out of 2012 batch. Wow, it's been around 8 to 9 years, but the feeling is just so fresh. So our batch was quite popular for having troublesome students, yet the best batch of toppers, artists, multi-talented people. I'm sure Chandralekha and Spandana would agree with me. So yes, we were like the most mischievous batch. So
you were mischievous. I was never mischievous.
Right, everybody knows.
No, Chandralekha, don't talk that. Don't say that.
Okay, so getting started, you know, about my journey, my life's journey. So first I would get started by saying that it's a great myth, rather than myth, I would put it across like a great notion that every school pass out has, every school pass out kid has, that yaar, ek bar college life start ho jaye, toh everything will be settled. Everything is going to be like full sorted. I'll be settled. But my dear friend, that's wrong. In fact, that's absolutely wrong. You need to walk the path. There's a huge journey that begins once you finish your school life. The school life is completely different from what you would be doing right from day one of your intermediate, that is your college life. The movies, the serials that you watch on TV, the kind of college life they display and portray is absolutely opposite. Okay, so there's a long pathway that you guys need to walk. Take that comes your way, learn, explore, bend, break, fall, bounce back, thrive, and do whatever it takes to have set settled. And for that, having the right roots is very, very important. And Bhadruka was my laid foundation, my roots for what I am today in my career and life. So yeah, the kind of confidence that I have right now to, you know, talk in front of you all and share my experience and be insightful comes right from Bhadruka, because I was never like this. I was a very shy and timid person who hesitated even to say hi to somebody who sat next to me. So yeah, from that person to somebody who can just randomly strike conversation with anybody who sits right next to me in the metro station or train. So yes, Bhadruka was like my laid foundation, the roots for my career, my life, for the person I am. And I heartily congratulate each and every one who have joined this huge family, because you guys are at the right place at the very right time. So yeah, congratulations you all. It's a moment that you just go back and pat your backs, because you have made the best decision of your life as you embark your career journey. So walking you all through my journey, my pathway. So Bhadruka was like the best opportunity and platform that I grabbed. It absolutely helped me to become a person from who never ever interacted with anybody, to a person who is really open, like in short, from an introvert to an extrovert, because the way the academics are planned, the extracurricular activities are planned for students, the NCC, NSS, all the various opportunities are absolutely, you know, inclined towards an individual's growth and, you know, development. It gives an opportunity to explore the inner you, inner potential, and gives every opportunity that you can just, you know, go ahead and grab. So that will help you to define you. Of course, along with academics, having an interest, hobby, extracurricular is equally important, and that's what Bhadruka promotes and encourages the best. So education gives you the knowledge, the conceptual idea, intelligence, whereas extracurricular activities gives you a chance to explore, think out of the box, be creative, and very importantly, personal development. Not that I never had opportunity for all this in my academic of schooling, but you know, the faculty plays a very, very important role in that, to motivate you, push you, and believing that you can do even when you fail to believe in yourself. So that's the turning point, the trigger point I had at Bhadruka. So the faculty were like so supportive, so encouraging, because they saw the potential in me and they pushed me, encouraged me in everything that I ever wanted to do, but I never did. So only because of their push, their motivation, their belief in me, I could take that step. And no matter what happens, I just went and I participated in each and everything. So yeah, in that way, I was like good in academics as well as, you know, in my extracurricular. So that's how I excelled. So yes, education and extracurricular will definitely give you that confidence, because at the end of the day, confidence is everything to show up your personality. And Bhadruka totally supports both. You all might not realize it now, but as you evolve in your career, jobs, you shall cherish the roots and opportunity that the college has been throwing at you and will be throwing at you. So yes, grab the best while you all are here and try even when you fail, because that's how I learned, the hard way and the best way. So yeah, talking about my career journey. So I finished my intro from Bhadruka, and then I absolutely tried my hands on CA, but I was like, no, numbers is something that I cannot do. So I just gave up on CA. And then after Bhadruka, I did my graduation, joined Francis, got my dual specialization. Then I got into a marketing job. And then during that, I got introduced to this NGO called Make a Difference. And currently I am into the leadership team as Ed Support Fellow, that is Educational Support Fellow, where I designed the Hyderabad's NGO's students' academic curriculum. So I'm into the leadership team of Hyderabad, and then I planned my MBA, got in my first job, and now currently I'm working as a senior human resource specialist. So I'm currently working as a human resource specialist at this place, Global Placements. Alongside, I also started my small startup and entrepreneur journey exactly a year back. So last lockdown, I am a health and wellness coach in association with Hub Life. So I started my health and wellness journey as well, did my nutritional course as we kickstarted the lockdown. So lockdown was bad to people. Of course, it was bad for everyone, but I pick it up as an opportunity. So, and I got into multiple courses and get started as a wellness and health coach, where I help people with their health goals, wealth, mental well-being. And not just that, I also initiated a small project directing towards women health and well-being, which is called the Boss Babe Project. It's been 3 months that I launched this project, which is completely inclined towards helping and supporting women on, you know, giving them an opportunity to do something on their own and start earning right from their house by investing 2 to 3 hours of their time while they take care of their family or children and whatsoever the responsibilities they have. So the main intention behind me starting this project was to, you know, so happens that post-marriage, when a woman goes on a maternity leave or something, it so happens, I don't blame the society, but that's how it is. When they return from the maternity leave, the chances, the job opportunity chances that they get are either they get back to their old roles or they start earning on part-time, or, you know, we always see that discrimination between the men and women work in the organization. And me coming from an HR background, I absolutely face that and see that in reality. So that was the main intention behind supporting a woman, a lady who wants to do something for herself but cannot because of the huge responsibilities that that she has on her head. So yeah, this program, so far I have been able to help and recruit around 13 strong women in my team. So it's just been 3 to 4 months and I could help 13 strong women to start and do something on their own and just create that financial independence. So yeah. So what? It's not just IT that can help you. There are many other opportunities, you know, you can just get started with. An idea can enlighten a future. So that was the main reason behind it. And what better than getting to stay with your family, take care of your kids, and equally contributing to the family as well. So yes, that's how my career journey has been. Of course, it was not easy. There were quite many ups and downs, but it's all up to you how you take up each and every opportunity that is thrown to you. So yes, apart from this, I am also an artist, a magician, and trust me, Bhadruka has been that one college that has supported me, not just to embrace my, you know, career opportunity, but me as an artist. So I have traveled a lot, especially during inter days. So yes, that gave me indeed an opportunity to be the best lady magician of Hyderabad and India. I represented our state in international competition, got crowned as Diva of Magic, so which is like a Merlin Award, and was represented at many international level opportunities. So it has been an amazing journey so far. And yeah, that's how I have explored, only because of the best college I could pick. Because honestly, after Bhadruka, whichever college I joined, I never got that support. So I'm not blaming it, but yeah, that's how the colleges are right now. But Bhadruka was that one platform. 2 years, I could not just concentrate on my career growth, but also my artistic growth. So thank you, Bhadruka, for that, because I am doing not just good in my career life, but also my artistic life. And that's a huge, huge accomplishment for myself. So yes, the only piece of advice I would say is, as you embark your journey, your new journey into making a brilliant career in whatever you guys are interested in, make sure you have a goal. Without goal, you will never lead a pathway. You will never have a direction. Or let's just say in simple words, you need to build that road to reach your destination. That is your goal. So explore each and every opportunity that comes to you, because that is how I learned. Invest your energy in the right direction. Invest your energy in the right direction. Face the distraction, because only if you face your distraction, you will overcome them. And next time when you face the same, you know what to do with, because you have the solution in hand. And that comes only by having a positive mindset. And it is a famous quote which goes like, you are equal to the 5 people that you're surrounded with. So make sure you have some positive people around you who encourage you and not pull you down. So be smart and wise in making friends, because this is your career. At the end of the day, you need to make decisions for your own. And yes, do good no matter whichever field you pick. It can be anything, an artistic field or your education field. If you're interested in something, just go ahead and embrace, but make sure you give your 101%. And yes, very important, never ever give up, because that's the only thing that will push you out of your comfort zone and be you. It's okay to make mistakes. Nobody here is perfect. It's okay not to be perfect after all, because even iPhone has a defect. So come on, we are just humans after all. So yes, just be you, do you, and do what makes you happy, and roar like Tigress, because this is your world, one life, just grab the best that you can. So yes, that's all from my end. In case you have any questions, you can throw up, and you can also find me on my Instagram page at @ Get Fit with Shelly. So you guys can always connect with me for any career opportunity or any career advice, health advice, mental well-being, or anything. So I'm always here to guide you, because yeah, that's what I love doing and enjoy doing and I have been doing. So yes, thank you, Badruka. Thank you, ma'am, for having me here. And I absolutely enjoyed being a part of this call and interaction. Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, Shelly. Thank you very much, Shelly, for your excellent speech. So your profession is human resource development. So you are encouraging the people, attracting the people by with your talking speech and all. Very nice. I felt very happy.
So thank you so much.
Follow your encouraging and motivational speech. So you joined in right place, human resource development in Deloitte. So all the best to you and achieve your goals. Thank you
so much, ma'am. Thank you, everyone. Have a nice day and all the best for your amazing 2 years.
Next, I will request our student, Malvika Anand. Yuva Gana Kokila. Malvika, please share your views and experiences with our students.
Where do I start? Yes, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yeah. Yes.
Where do I start, ma'am? I'm just lost in
very
the.
Nice, very nice.
How are you? How are you, ma'am?
Fine.
So long. How are you, Deepa, ma'am?
Everyone is good.
Firstly, I'd like to thank Badruka family, Asha ma'am, for remembering me and calling me today. It's absolute honor to be today here, and as soon as I got a call from Asha ma'am, you know, I was just lost in this 2015 to 2017. The time that I spent in Badruka College was absolutely amazing, and I don't know where to start. I just don't know where to start and what to write, what to talk. I am just so blank. But I'd like to start with the journey that I had in college. I'll talk a little bit.
Malvika, first, yes, in the beginning, I request you to sing a song for you.
Yes, ma'am. First, this is always please. The exercise in college as well. Every function, Malvika, where are you? We want to hear a song.
So that's an opportunity like this.
I'll sing one song. Instead, I'm not singing a prayer song this time. I'll sing something.
Okay.
Humko mili hai aaj ghadiyan naseeb se जी भर के देख ले जी हमको करीब से फिर आपके नसीब में ये बात हो ना हो शायद फिर से जन मुलाकात हो न हो लग जा गले की भेंट हसी रात हो न हो शायद फिर से जन्म मुलाकात हो लग जा गई
से है। Well done, Malvika. Thank you very much.
No, please don't thank me, because I've got a lot from this college, and I owe a lot to this college because I was very young when I started singing, but the initial years were easy because I was in school and I was able to manage my studies and all. But as in when I got out of my 10th, I was really panicky and I didn't know where to, you know, how do I continue my music, because music was something that I was very passionate about and I didn't want to let go of that. And I got that encouragement from Bhadruka and all my teachers who supported me all through my life with, you know, even if I missed classes. Oh, girls, I must tell you this. Huh? Don't take it to your advantage, but I'm just going to tell you a little secret. So do achieve your dreams by following your passion. You can miss classes, but for genuine reasons. And yeah. I'm sure our teachers are so wonderful and so helpful that they're going to teach you. And they will never stop you from achieving your dreams. Because I'm a perfect example of that, because I was always into shootings and classes. I was always on my second priority. I was going to competitions and all of that. And not one day did they come and tell me, you know, Malvika, you're not attending classes. Your marks are going down. They never came and told me that statement, which always gave me an upper hand in music to achieve there. And then, of course, exam times, I used to concentrate for my studies as well, because this is really important. And yeah, you can miss classes, but don't take it to your advantage and miss simply, because our teachers are there to catch you. They're very smart, smarter than you think, okay? So, yeah, so I'll start from the very first day of my college. I was also a newbie like you guys, just out of school. I just finished my 10th and I didn't know. I was also a very introvert kind of a person, not talking much to others and stuff. Just like, hi, this kind of a girl. But it was a second home for me. College was second home for me, and all of them made me feel so comfortable. And all the teachers were not just like teachers, they were more like your friends, and always came out to us, reached out to us if we had any problem. And you know, I could go and personally talk to Asha ma'am, Lakshmi ma'am, Deepa ma'am any day and say, ma'am, I'm not able to understand this, can you please explain me once more? And they were never hesitant for this, okay? So they were always saying, no problem, Malvika, we will explain you. And see, that is a very good trait of a teacher, very good teacher. And all of them are here to help you. So don't ever hesitate to go and ask them whatever you have. And even your personal problems, trust me, they're very homely and they're very motherly. And it was a beautiful experience, ma'am. Those 2 years where I changed as a person, I evolved as a better person and got to know my strengths as well. So there was this freshers day as well. And I remember that was the first time I took part in, you know, Miss Freshers contest, and I got the first runner up. So that kind of gave me a boost that, you know, not just singing or not just one thing, it made you realize so much in you. So there's a lot in you that is untapped yet. So this is the time where you explore yourself, like don't have any boundaries around you. So explore as much as possible, study well and have ambitions, have goals and follow your passion. Don't ever give up on them, because trust me, I've traveled a few years in my passion as well. That is never going to let you down. It's always going to help you somewhere or the other. Even if you don't make it your profession, it's definitely going to help you. So it'll have an edge over the others. So you'll be advantageous over the others. So don't ever give up on that. And academics should not be a reason for you to step back. It should, in fact, be a step further, like a stepping stone for the future, you know, because I feel personally, if I was only into music, I would have been like a 10. But now because I have my academics as well, I feel like a 100, because I have academics and profession. So don't undermine your passion. At the same time, don't give up on your education as well. And coming to my experiences with the teachers, I'd like to share 2 lines with each of the teachers that I got time to spend with. I'll start with Asha ma'am. Asha ma'am is the one ma'am that comes to my mind whenever I hear English. Okay, so first day I walked in and the first hour was Asha ma'am's. she just comes into the class and we're all tense, you know, what to do, what are we supposed to talk, we don't know how ma'ams are here and all. She was so humble and so homely, and she came and spoke to us, you know, how were you all, how was the summer holidays, all of this, and it made us feel so comfortable. And any day I could walk up to her and say, ma'am, you know, I don't feel well or something like that, anything personal, I could go share it with her. Similarly, Lakshmi ma'am is she is the one who introduced me to economics, and trust me, it's my favorite subject until today. Like, till today, I remember Lakshmi ma'am because of her personality, because of her sweet nature, because most importantly, because of economics. She's the one who introduced me to economics, and she's the one who made me love that subject. And it's a very important thing that a teacher is a very good teacher only can make you love some subject. And I started loving economics because of ma'am. And I never got less than 99 in economics, ma'am. I never wanted to disappoint ma'am as well. And Hindi. Oh, my God. I'm being a South Indian. It was a tough task for me to clear Hindi exams. But Deepa ma'am never made me feel like, you know, you don't belong to the Hindi speaking category. You really do well, Malvika, you can do it. I think there was a first class where I made a mistake in some sentence, and she was not humiliating or insulting. She came up to me and said, you know, beta, you're supposed to write like this. It's okay, no problem. And she was so humble and friendly with us. Any mischief we do used to go and tell her. No, ma'am, I remember your classes. And we all used to be scared of you at the same time. You were very fun, but very scared also of you. So we have so many. And we were also the mischievous lot of my class, like Shobha and Renu, and all of us were like a very mischievous lot in the class. But absolutely fun to have been your students, ma'am. And coming to the college, they have an amazing canteen, guys. Go check out when the college opens up. You have amazing, yummy, yummy stuff. And college is also beautiful. You must go. And I know it is virtual now, but I'm sure you guys are lucky enough to get it soon because everything's going to be normal soon. And one advice I would like to give you is follow your passion. Never give up. I know studies are a little tough for people like us who are into extracurricular activities. You've seen such good alumni here who've been entrepreneurs, who've been HRs and, you know, into different fields. So they've all studied, they've all gone through this. And when we are able to do it, I'm sure you guys also will be able to do it. Yeah, come on. You're also going to do it. And college is never going to stop you from doing anything. And trust me, you guys are lucky to be here today. You're very lucky to have got a seat in Bhadruka Junior College, and make full use of it. Extract as much as possible from the teachers, learn as much as possible. Don't have boundaries around you to limit yourself from doing something. I know you're all scared to try something new and all, but trust me, this is the time you have to let yourself out. And don't hesitate to answer, and because this is the time where if you restrict yourself to answering or feel shy, you will never be able to come out. So please, I request all of you to speak out and have fun, have loads of fun, learn a lot, explore your life, grow as a person, and lastly, enjoy your life. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for having me today. It was an absolute pleasure to be here. And I'm always thankful for Bhadruka faculty for giving me so much support. And even now, you people support me so much. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Malika. We recollected our old memories again in the college. So with this moment. So all the best, Malika.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Finally, I would like to invite our student, Chandralekha, who is very active and naughty girl and intelligent in the class. I request her to share her experiences with our students. Chandralekha, over to you.
Hi, ma'am.
Hello. How are you?
I'm good, ma'am. How are you?
Fine.
Hi, everyone. Please, small correction. I am not the naughty one. I was doing good in the studies.
Yeah, you are good. That's what intelligent also added. Naughty, charming, and beautiful. Intelligent, everything.
overall.
I'm very sharif. Very, very sharif. I couldn't even talk. So I was that sharif.
Right.
Okay, so
please share your views and experiences with our students.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so now I'm starting to feel nervous, but okay. Good afternoon, first of all. And I really don't want to bore all of you. I know you're trying your best efforts to listen to us. But yeah, let me make it really quick. So I'm from 2012 batch. I was from CEC. So way back then when I told people that I'm from CEC, they're like, CEC. Don't ever let people question your choices, the decisions you make. I think I've had the best 2 years of my life, like how Shelly, Spandan and others told, we are from the same batch. So some of you are maybe you might be sleepy, maybe you're bored or you're excited, but I think I can tell you this one for sure, right in the beginning, that you are in the best, safest and the right place that you can be for the next 2 years. I think, you know, in a way, I consider myself very lucky over you guys, because we had a campus class and all, but now you're having all these virtual classes. So you, maybe you're missing a little fun, but I think it's still okay. You have these amazing faculty, amazing lecturers. So talking about lecturers and faculty, they all have been amazing. They'll be your friends when you are really good, when you want your help and all. They'll be your worst enemies if you are actually doing something wrong. They will bend you and they'll put you in your right space. So be very careful how you draw lines with them. And they'll be your mothers when you actually are looking for a kind of support. So I remember this incident where we all went to Pune for our trip. Imagine bunch of teenagers, you know, I'm sure most of you must be knowing, you know, like who have siblings at home, it's very difficult for your parents to manage. You're constantly fighting for this or that. Alanti, imagine you have like 50 or 60 teenagers. So all the lecturers, they took us to Pune, hats off to their energies or whatever. So each and every day they made us feel comfortable. We never felt like, oh, missing home. Never. They made us feel very warm, and you know, we were all together, we were having fun. So I think it's the best trip of my life ever. And yeah, moving forward, what I do and all. So right from my very young age, I wanted to be in media. I wanted to pursue something in media. So when I came to my intermediate, I realized I want to become a filmmaker. By then, I was also doing multiple things. Like I was anchoring for Doordarshan, and I was doing some radio shows. So never ever, like how Malvika mentioned, the college will not stop you from doing what you want or pursuing your dreams or following your passion. So I remember the days where morning I used to go and do some early morning live show and then again rush back to college. And in case I missed something, I always had them to help me. So they never said things like, don't do this. Why are you late to the class? You missed this class. Or why do you want to go early? Never, never. I think that is the best kind of thing that can ever happen to you. Because moving forward, when you see your friends from other colleges, you know, who are going from morning to night in this rut to study, that's when you'll realize that life is not just that. It's beyond that. And here at Bhadruka, you'll have your friends, your faculty who will support you in every possible way to achieve your dreams. So yes, I was doing my CEC, and then I was also simultaneously working as an RJ. Sorry, anchor for Doordarshan and doing a couple of other radio shows. Then I went on, I pursued my mass communications and journalism. After that, I started my internship at Radio Mitri Hyderabad Telugu. Then they said, oh, nice, you're doing good work. Let us give you a job. So they gave me work as an RJ, job as an RJ. So I started working as an RJ. But still somewhere in my mind, I knew this is not for me. I should become a filmmaker. So I resigned my job and then I joined Telugu film. It's called Balakrishnudu as an assistant director. The first day on my set, I knew nothing, like blank. I didn't even know anything. And then there are people running all around in the set. Hey, this corner, and people screaming, yelling, and it was chaos. And I was like, okay, am I even in the right place? I was that dumb and I didn't know anything. But I think what I learned from the college is that whatever situations you are in, whatever circumstances you are in, you should never give up and at least put an effort in the first place. And I think that's what I've done. And today I've successfully worked as an assistant director and associate directors on a couple of films and web films. And now I'm in a place where I'm writing my own scripts and I'm building scripts for people. So I think this is all possible only because in the age, you know, that early or mid-teens, where you get the right kind of atmosphere to grow in, that's where you have that impact in your coming years. So I realize that very often, and then I feel very lucky. I had got like good lecturers, and we had Mahalakshmi ma'am for accounts, and then I took up Sanskrit, but then my Hindi ma'am back then, Preeti ma'am, she was very nice, she was very sweet, and my Hindi sucks, even today it sucks, so but she helped me a lot with my Hindi. So I think overall you get this feeling that okay, I can do better, I can do this, I can do that, and there are people who are constantly helping you, and I think that is the best thing you can ever have. Okay, I wrote something else, so let me, oh yeah, and the age that you are in, let me tell you, you feel like, you know, a lot of injustice is happening to you. The whole world is cornering you. People are asking you to do things. People are asking you not to do things. Nobody is giving you attention or respecting your views or that kind of thing. It actually happens, you know, maybe it can come from your friends or it can come from your parents, the expectations, the pressure. But trust me, don't listen to them. Please don't listen to them. And in life, you should always, always be willing to start over again. And like Shaili mentioned, make mistakes. Please, please do make mistakes, as many mistakes as possible, because only from mistakes you will learn what you want, what you don't want. I think I've done a lot in my life, and that's why I'm very happy. I've learned from my mistakes. Make sure that you don't repeat the same mistakes, because you know that kind of makes you look like a loser. But you know, start making good mistakes, more mistakes, that will take you to a better place. And you should be willing to start over again. Let's say you do something, you don't like it, and then you want to start over. There are hundreds of people telling you, see, I told you not to do this, you did this, now see, you are suffering. Let them say, it's okay, don't listen to them. Start over again. You need to have lots and lots of patience, because the world outside is not as safe as home or a college. It's always ready to throw dirt on you. So be very strong, be very certain about things you want. And in case you're not certain, let's say sometimes you don't have clarity on what you want, you're not sorted. It is okay. It's fine not to have clarity. It's fine not to have a goal. But make sure that eventually when you're going forward, you are happy with the decisions that you made in your life. Never ever have any regrets in life. There are certain people from my class, a few people who actually had many dreams of doing this and doing that, pursuing many things. And sadly, they couldn't. They said, oh, we got married.
Hello.
Can start. Yeah, sorry. Some network problem, I think. Hello. Hello, Sindhareka. Any problem? What happened? Any network problem?
I think due to network, she's not on the call.
Yeah, network problem.
Mm-hmm. She's not here on the call. I'll just check with her.
Yeah. Hello. Hello. So the it's time, girls. Yeah, sir, you go. Yes, so it's time, girls, to express the vote of thanks. Thank you, Chandralekha. Thank you very much for your encouraging, inspiring speech. So it helps our students very much, and we felt very happy for recollecting college days memories with you. All the best. All the best, Chandralekha. A vote of thanks on behalf of the Bhadrika Junior College for Girls, and on my personal behalf, I express thanks to all the dignitaries for taking time out of your busy schedule to be with us on this occasion, and my special thanks to our alumni for their presence on this occasion and your inspiring speeches, and also sharing your views and experiences with our freshers are excellent. I wish you all the best and have a bright future ahead. All the best to the freshers. So we deeply feel that, like every other bachelor's, you will also hold the name of our college high and contribute immensely wherever you go with the knowledge you gain from here. I also extend thanks to our respected principal madam for encouraging us to conduct this event successfully. Thank you very much to all. Thank you.
Wish you all the best, girls.
Wish you all the best to everyone.
All the best, guys.
All the best, everyone.
All the best.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you,
ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
End this program. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Bye, bye. Thank you. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am.